Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to the online classes of math. Today we are going to discuss the next topic, addition. So students, firstly we are going to discuss addition of big numbers. The operation to find the total of the different values is called addition. Now let us discuss what are the rules of addition. So first we have to add ones, then tens, then hundreds, and then thousands, and so on for more digits. We should solve mentally. Here you can see in this one, first we have added ones digit with 7, 9, 8, and 3. After adding, we'll get 27. So for that, 7 we have to write, and tens digit will give carry over the next place. Now we have to add the tens place. So we'll add 4, 8, 9, and 9. With this one, we should add, we have given carry. So after adding, we get 32. In 32, we will write 2 below the tens place, and 3 we will give carry over the hundreds place. Now we will add the hundreds place. So we will get 23, in which we will write 3 below the hundreds place, and we give carry 2 over the thousands place. Now we have to add the thousands place. So we get 26 by adding the carry. So the answer is 26,327. Now, students, let us talk about some facts of addition. So first one is, addition of small numbers can be done horizontally. For example, here you can see, first we have to add the ones digit, and then we'll give carry over the tens digit. After that, we will add the tens place and we will write the answer. Now the second fact is, addition of large number done vertically, written under the place value chart. Here I have taken an example of place value chart. So you can see with this example, we can solve the numbers with the help of place values chart vertically. Now let us talk about the properties of addition. So there are 4 properties of addition: order property, grouping property, additive property of 0, and additive property of 1. So we will talk about each property one by one. Now let us talk about the first property, which is order property. The sum of two numbers remains same even if we change the order of the numbers. For example, here you can see we have added two numbers by changing their order, and at last we can see their answer is still same. So from here we can say it doesn't change the sum if we change the order of the numbers. Now let's see the second property, which is grouping property. While adding three numbers, the numbers can be grouped in any ways. The sum remains the same. For example, here you can see I have taken two examples of same numbers, and at end you can see the sum in both examples are same. So from here we can say it doesn't change the sum even if we change the group of the numbers while adding the three numbers. And students, you should remember this: we will always add the numbers in bracket first. Now The third property, which is additive property of zero. It says the sum of a number and zero is the number itself. For example, here I have taken 6854 plus zero. So after adding, you can see what you will get again, 6854. It means here if we add zero with any number, so it will not change the answer. We will get the answer as the number itself. Now the last property, which is additive property of 1, or you can say it as successor. So it says when we add 1 to the number, the sum is the successor of the number. For example, 48,976. When we add 1 with this number, so we'll get 48,977, which is the successor of the number. Again, in the second example, you can see the number 9,999 is adding with 1, so we will get the successor of the number, which is 10,000. Now students, I hope you have understood the properties of addition, as we have discussed each property briefly. Now let's talk about the word problems of addition. For that, I would like to tell you a story. Here, this is Jamie, and he is a shopkeeper who sells apples. And he sold apples in 3 days. 3,860 apples were sold on Monday. 2,343 apples sold on Tuesday. And 1,847 apples he sold on Wednesday. Now he want to find out how many total apples he sold on these 3 days. So how do we find out? So with the help of word problem, we can solve it. So for that, first we have to make the statements. So statements we will make like this. Apples sold on Monday is equals to 3,860. Apples sold on Tuesday is equals to 2,343. Apples sold on Wednesday is equal to 1,847. Now for finding the total number of apples sold in these 3 days, we have to add. So after adding all three numbers, we will get the total number of apples sold. So it is 8,050. Therefore, the answer is Jamie sold 8,050 apples in all. So I hope you have understood how do we make the statements for the story problem or word problem. Now let's talk about the estimation. What is estimation? So to estimate a sum or difference, first round each numbers to its greatest place value, and then we add or subtract mentally. So students, for find out the estimation, first we should know the round off. How do we round off to the nearest tens, hundreds and thousands and so on? So as you have already studied round off to the nearest 10 and 100 in the previous class, so now we will study about the round off to the nearest 1000. So it says finding out the multiple of 1000, which is nearest to the given number, is called rounding a number to the nearest 1000. So here are some working rules for rounding a number to the nearest 1000. In which first step is, in order to round off a number to the nearest 1000, We look at the digit at hundreds place. Now, the second step is, if it is more than 5, means the hundreds digit is more than 5, then increase the digit at the thousands place by 1 and place 0 at hundreds, tens and ones place. Now the third step is, if it is less than 5, means the hundreds place is less than 5, then replace the hundreds, tens and ones digit by 0 by keeping all the digits same. Now let us see with some example. So round off 9378 to the nearest thousands. Here the hundreds digit is 3 and 3 is less than 5. So replace each of the digits at hundreds, tens and ones place by 0 and keeping the remaining digits as it is. Therefore, round off to the nearest thousand of 9378 is equals to 9000. Now, let's see with another example. Here, I've taken an example of round off 5830 to the nearest thousands. So, solution is, here the hundreds digit is 8 and 8 is greater than 5. So, we replace each of the digit at hundreds, tens and ones place by 0 and the thousands digit or thousands place will increase by 1. Therefore, round off to the nearest thousand of 5830 is equals to 6000. I hope you have understood how do we round off the numbers to the nearest thousand. Similarly, you can do for 10,000 also by looking at the thousands place and replacing thousand, hundreds, tens and ones digit by 0 in the same manner we have done for nearest thousand. Now, let us see what is estimated sum and how do we do estimated sum. So, students, here I am going to take an example. Add 2254 and 3659. Find the actual sum and compare it with the estimated sum. It means you have to first find the actual sum and the estimated sum. After that, you will compare both the answers. So first here is the actual sum. So for actual sum, we will add the actual numbers, which are 2254 and 3659. After solving, we'll get the answer as 5913. Now we will find out the estimated sum. So, for estimated sum, first we have to do the round off to the nearest thousands because here it is 4-digit numbers. For 2254, the round off to the nearest thousand is 2000. And for 3659, the round off to the nearest thousand is 4000. So, after finding out the round off to the nearest thousand, we will add both the rounded numbers. So we get 6000 as the estimated sum. Now the actual sum is 5913, which is quite close to the estimated sum, which is 6000. So this is how you will find out the actual sum and estimated sum for the numbers. Now let us see with another example. So find estimated sum of 2910 and 6159 by rounding the number to the nearest thousands. So solution, how do we solve? So first we have to write 2910 is rounded to the nearest thousand, so it will give you 3000. Now, the second number 6159 is rounded to the nearest thousand, so we get 6000. Now we have to find the estimated sum. Therefore, the estimated sum is equal to 3000 plus 6000, which is equal to 9000. So, I hope you have understood how do we find out the estimated sum for the numbers by rounding it to the nearest thousand. Now, here I am going to give you an activity. So, here are some questions. First, you have to write these questions in your rough copy and arrange them into column. Then you have to find their sum. That's all for today's topic. I hope you have understood all the topics clearly. And